Devlearn. My name is Leo. Your name?
I'm Terry.
Terry from?
Terry from Toronto.
Toronto.
From another age.
Yeah, we actually has a Vancouver R&D center. So we are Canadian divisions we have. So this is providing the way how we show presenter and presenting material together. Because presentation has to have two important things. One is the presenter, the other one is the presenting material we have to show there. So now everybody is showing the presenting material separate screen. So there's a problem to show this one in smart device. Smart device has only one screen where they have to show more interactive way. So that way we can go something like that way, something like that way. Oh, Sharon, welcome. So we have a studio like this. When we have a virtual monitor, we have a switcher here, so you can make some content switching here. And also we have a monitor too. We have something like anything you can bring. And then we have a pointer. So our pattern is how we combining pointer and so changing. Okay? So if you have the tablet, you can do everything. You can change the color here. We have all the tools here. So the first pattern we make is a pointer operated device. And then second one is we have a virtual monitor flying method. So we make a proper the tools for them to change every virtual monitor in a space in any location they can move. They can move back and forth. So whatever they have a layer here, you can go. And also we have a band and then change.
Talk to me about your encoding.
So encoding we have actually MPEG-4 and flash. And also AVI with a very low.
Can you encode X264?
This is basically X264. But what I'm saying is.
Can you encode X?
Yes.
H or X?
H.
Can you do X264?
Not now. We have no codec by ourselves. Maybe Adobe has. So we have a.
No, Adobe does. Something like Wirecast or XSplit. They do X264.
Yeah, we just use here flash media encoder inside. We are not using others. It's just Adobe free main concept based engine we use. This is working everywhere. So we use a flash media encoder. We're streaming this one to any place. Okay. By the way, my engineer is a key developer in main concept. He wrote the codec for this one. Yeah. Yeah, we are the MPEG company. We provide many MPEG engineer to worldwide. Adobe is a good supporter for media industry, I believe. As long as they doesn't do anything competing with me, they're a very good company. We are always afraid. If they mind, if they do anything, they can make it much better than I do. Okay. This is a big problem. So please, work together. Don't try to go here. I'm very afraid of. Okay?
So are you selling the software or are you selling...
A complete system, yeah. The machine, you can go and you can connect your camera, your green studio. The other way is we just providing the complete system. Because I found the building studio is a quite big problem because they have to construct the rooms, they have a painting, they have a lighting, all the bureaucratic process, they charge huge money, about $100,000 easily they're asking. So now I'm breaking this one. It's kind of the providing lighting by ourselves. So even they said a very special light, I don't mind. I just put this one. I guarantee this one will make a good chroma key. And we have algorithm, we have a green street. This is a much better than any other chroma key machine. The painting cannot make it such a nice chroma key. We have lighting, we have a console desk. They put this one very easily. And this is a perfect. So why they should pay the $100,000 for this kind of environment? This is more than enough. So I just say, please use this Sony HD or Panasonic HD camera. This is more than enough. Because this one has a good quality. The only problem is this one has everything automatic. This is what I like. I just use a $70 Shure. Because this one, in case you have a video conference, there's audio from speaker, you need to feedback from your ear. Then you have automatically control distance. No echo problem, perfect environment. I just ask them, just use as I recommend it. Don't use a broadcast speaker microphone. It makes all the problem. They don't know how to set up camera in the different color temperature. No. This is always make a better color. They don't have to make a real color. They just make a beautiful color as they make a DSLR technology. This is more than enough.
So you're capturing the video through a video capture card?
Yes, we have our own card, multiple input and output. We have our own capture driver.
You have your own capture card and yes. capture driver.
Yes, and because we need a real time. You know, the latency is very important for real time presentation. If you use other companies, about 4 to 8 frame delay, no way for live. And then this one is just feeding to flash media encoder from Adobe.
So I can publish to any flash media server that I want.
Exactly, because it's a flash media encoder inside. We just use the SDK to make it work like this way. So that way, so once you link this one flash media encoder and going YouTube, going Skype, then means all the smart world is connected. As long as you make a video feeding into one stream, this is our pattern for presentation, how we combine the content and actor and virtual world. Camera and notebook input, and also another camera for audience.
Yes.
So we bring audience response. When the audience make a question, immediately audience coming in. And now new version has automatic face direction detection. So the speaker don't have to worry. He's just watching students, his face speak. He's just watching another students pointing. This guy coming here together. The two PTG camera there. The face detection we license from Netherlands company. You looks like a Netherlands person, yeah? No? Anyway,
I'm a Brit.
Okay. Anyway, we are going that way. So everything, we are trying to remove everything here. He just present. Everything will have a video with a broadcast quality. So imagine every school, every conference room, even in this most advanced e-learning conference, they are not recording like this quality. So once they have a recording in the classroom, as I show in my video, every video is actually better than live lecture. They don't have to come to there to listen video. They have to listen video before they come. And when they arrive, they have a talking discussion, question and answer. I call this is a flipped conferencing. It's like a flipped teaching. Let's work together to bring flipped teaching industry. Every classroom we have to change. Students has a lot of time, they boring, sleeping there. That's why they make the flipped teaching method, flipped class. But how can they make a good teaching for students to watch at the home? Nobody will watch the video at home, even there is no teachers. So I'm trying to bring beautiful studio-like video there. And then this one going to Skype or the YouTube, everything is ready. So this is only one thing missing in this industry. Once we have this one, everything changes. School change, conference change.
So can you take this output, so this output becomes a virtual camera as an input to another system?
Actually, we just feed out this final result.
So you feed this out.
Yeah.
This you encode using FMLE, right?
Yeah.
Okay. But can this composite video output that you're producing here, can it show up as a virtual input to something like Adobe Connect?
Yes, exactly. I understand. This output, we are providing virtual capture drive. This output going to our card, we have a capture from the card. And then we provide this one as a camera input for Skype, as a camera input for Connect Pro, as a camera input for WebEx. So Connect Pro has a two-way. They can just capture from output screen. In that case, frame drop is slightly slow. But if they select camera as a input, then this one going directly to Connect Pro.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So immediately this one become everything. That's why we put this way. So once you have eStudio, iStudio, you have Skype, you have YouTube, Hangout, everything there. And Connect Pro WebEx is going there.
Okay. Pricing?
Pricing here, this one is... The